Hello guys, how are you doing? Long time no see since last year. So happy new year everyone. I'm here to show you this map. It's the AE projection map made in Japan. So I'm gonna give a little bit of details on this map, starting by the way that it's displayed. I'm pretty much used to the map being displayed like this, you know, with South America here and Australia on the other side on top. But this, as you may see, is different. We see the world map is written in white right here, so you can hardly see. But I'm going to be showing some details to you. I'm going to lay down this map on the table and go show all the details. But let me tell you a little bit about this map. This is a made in Japan map. It's been published since 1973. It's on its 10th edition, and this one was the last edition was released in 2008. So this map that I have right here, they have been on sale in Japan since 2008, but the first edition came out in 1973. So I was quite surprised because I don't see these kind of maps being sold in big bookstores in the US or even in other countries, unless now, like in Brazil, street vendors are selling the Gleason's map and other projections of the AE map. But as far as like this one, I have never seen for sale in stores, like big time map stores. Like I'm gonna show you on the website exactly how I've ordered this map. But let me give you a little bit more details here. As you see, world map is written on top. Right, they don't have Antarctica as we see on the Gleason's map. They just have a white line with the longitude lines. For example, in Africa it's zero longitude, then you have 15 west, and then you have 30 west, 45 west, 60 west. So it goes the same thing here, 15 east, 30 east, 45 east, and then it goes on. So I'm going to be laying the map here on the table, and I'm going to show you. But also I'm going to show you guys how to go to the website and order one. But I don't know if they ship outside Japan. This map cost me ¥1,300, about $12. And I spent another $12 in shipping. And so about $25, and it's laminated, so it's pretty shiny. That's why I have in this position, because I got the window open, and if I change the position, it's gonna reflect the light, so you guys won't be able to see. But it's a pretty nice map. It's 78 centimeters by 78 centimeters. It's a square map, about what, 37 inches to 40 inches, okay? First let me show you on the website, because I already have the computer ready, how to order this map, okay? And then I'm going to lay this map flat here on the table and show some of the details. Okay, we are here on the website, okay? Now, the first website that I went, it was in Japanese actually. So let me go to the website in Japanese. Okay, this is the shop where I bought this map. Okay, mapshop.co.jp. So sometimes you will not find this option here, English, which makes it hard for you to order. But you see everything here is in Japanese. So this page here I already had. I'm gonna place this link on the description so you can go straight to the map. But it's kind of hard for you to find on the website like this. I tried several times, you know, enter the product name, because everything is in Japanese. Google is translating to English. But they have that's what I did. Also, they have an email address. You can send them a message and ask them if they would ship this a map overseas and how much that would cost. So it's called Buyodo, okay? Map shop Buyodo. No, it's not Buyodo, Buyodo, because this is the Japanese Buyodo map shop, okay? So here you have the name of the map. It's the Arctic Center World Laminator World Map. Some of the details, the scale, reduced scale, 1 over 45 million. Alright, that's the scale of this map. The size is 78 centimeters by 78 centimeters. And the price in yen right here, 1,320 yen, tax included. But the problem is if you order online, you're going to have to register first time. And I had trouble. I was on my cell phone and I had to go back several times, actually four times, and start all over again. But when I made the purchase, I found out that I had four maps here included in my cart because I tried four times. But even though I tried again, started from the beginning, the cart kept the purchase. So at the end, when I got the email, the confirmation, it said four maps, that I bought four maps. So I sent them an email. I explained to them in English that I had only purchased one map, but I had trouble, registering. So they were very nice. They just sent me one map and they deducted the difference. So you may be careful. I think you should, if you decide to buy this map and decide to open an account with them, like register, do it on the computer, don't do it on the cell phone, it gets difficult. Okay, so this is the name of the map, and it says to enlarge the image, which I did, but it's not a high resolution, okay? So even if you save this, it's not going to be a high resolution image. You won't be able to use much for printing or anything. I wish they had a printing version of this, a high resolution file, so we could use for, publishing, making videos or stuff. But this is what they give you right here. So let's see here, what else? I think they buy old maps too, And this store was founded like in 1896. So it's, all they do is like maps, And the AE map, they have had it since 1973. This edition here, the 10th edition, was released in 2008. Okay, so this is the website. I'm gonna link this page exactly, so you go straight to the page where you can order the map, this one, if you want. But if you're good in Japanese, if you can speak it well, you probably won't see this option here, English. It's gonna be all in Japanese, but it's pretty hard to find this map, so that's why I'm going to place the link here, so you can go straight to the page. And if you decide to order the map, you can send them an email and ask them how much they would charge shipping to your country. Okay, so now I'm going to lay down the map on the table and show some more details. Alright guys, here's some details of the map. I'm sorry if you see like a reflex, because this map is laminated, so it's really shiny. You see there, scale of meridians in thousands of kilometers, and azimuthal equidistant projection, tangent and north pole, 1 over 45 million. Okay, and then there is some stuff in Japanese there, and says below here, copyright 1973. Okay, this is when it's hard to see, but it has there 1973. Right, and here some are details of the map. There's like the company, the year, and this is like 1973, and then the last edition 2008. Okay, if you read Japanese, you probably will be able to read more about it. So you see here, Antarctica is actually where they have only the longitudes line. You see here Australia, it's written both in English and in Japanese. You have a lot of details, but everything is bilingual, English and Japanese. It's a pretty detailed map, North Pacific Ocean, then the South Pacific Ocean right here. Okay. As I told you, the orientation is quite different from how we normally look. South America is on the other side. It says their world map. But the oceans, it is written like, it's not like the Gleason's map. They write everything, you know, like one direction. They do go around. So Russia, it's spelled differently. Look, Russia. Okay, Mongol. It's a very detailed map. You have China there. I really liked it. All these islands here, Indonesia. And then you have, you know, Africa and everything. Now, let's look here, the United States. They don't have like other states, like, you know, cities. Oh, they do have. It's not just dividing states. Okay, now again, yeah, they show North America being much smaller than South America. This is probably the way it is because I drove from Florida to New York City in 24 hours, me and three friends. And we also drove from Atlanta to San Diego. It took us about three days. But Brazil, when we tried to go from Brazil to Bolivia, we drove a lot and then like, you know, 24 hours driving. And then when we asked the guy how long it would take us to get to Bolivia, they said, well, it's going to take another 24 hours. So, I mean, non-stop. When we crossed the States, we only drove during daytime from like 8 a.m. until 6 p.m. and then we stopped in hotels. So that's why it took us 3 days. We could have done probably 30 hours if we had gone non-stop. But in Brazil, we drove 24 hours non-stop, and we were actually half. We were here in Mato Grosso. And then when we found out that would take us another 24 hours to get to Bolivia, we decided not to. We wanted to go to Pumapunku at that time. I was a big fan of the ancient alien stuff. So let's go to Pumapunku. Let's check those structures there. I was with an American guy. But we decided not to. Okay. All right. So this is the AE projection map made in Japan. It's a big map. All right. So let's go back to the video. Hey guys. So I hope you guys liked this map here. I liked it. There's a lot of potential here. There are a lot of Japanese people coming to know Flat Earth right now. I have been getting friend requests here. Now, let me tell you this. A lot of people think I'm Japanese. I'm not Japanese. I'm married to a Japanese woman. I'm originally from Brazil, but I live in Japan. We have two daughters. Our two daughters were born in the U.S. when we were living there. And my daughter was in New York a couple weeks ago, and she's back here in Japan. We are planning to go to New Zealand, and actually I want her to stay sometime in New Zealand working there. I can stay up to 1 year in Japan, in New Zealand, I think, working. So I want to tell you something also. I apologize, guys. I enjoy making videos, but I have been sick lately, and I'm telling you now what's going on. I have been diagnosed with this thing called adrenal insufficiency, which is really complicated. It kind of drains your energy. Like, I'm talking about, like, I can't walk, let's say, 100 meters, you know, sometimes. I have trouble. It's just like how my energy disappears. Sometimes I can't even get out of bed. I mean, but sometimes I feel great, okay? I had a good summer last year. I even wrote my book. But then, you know, especially in winter time, I get really in bad shape. Now, I know in the U.S., Like, I've been watching videos by Dr. Eric Berg, and there are treatments for that. They give you hydrocortisone. People take hydrocortisone, and they have a normal life. But in Japan, this thing is not, like, recognized as a disease, so they don't really give you any medicine. So when I have been to the hospital a couple times, and the doctor just tells me, well, every time you feel really, really bad, come back here. They give me a shot, and then I'll start feeling better for a couple of days. So what I have been doing, watching Dr. Eric Berg, I have been taking some stuff. You know, one of them is this thing here he recommends is ashwagandha. Okay. Not advertising anything, just telling the name of the stuff. And I'm just trying to make this thing go away and have a normal life, okay? And I've been taking this fish oil here too. This was actually my wife's. And she was taking this for her hair, actually. She had trouble, like, falling hair. But she quit taking, so I decided, let's go ahead and take. Anything is, you know, better than nothing. And sometimes I get messages, people ask me, hey, you dye your hair or wearing a wig or something? No, I don't. My hair is going gray, but I noticed after taking this stuff, my hair started going darker again, and I don't know why. I don't know, maybe it's like side effect, but my hair is brown. But if I go out in the, you know, daytime clear, you can see lots of gray hair, especially here, right? My father had, you know, dark hair until his 70s, and he's 80-something now. Now his hair is all gray, but until he was 70, he still had dark hair. So I don't know, maybe genetics. I don't know. I don't understand about it. My hair is not falling or anything, you know. It's just the way it is, you know. I don't know. I had friends who at 19 lost their hair, you know, like went bald at 19. Well, that's nothing. I'm just telling you about, you know, what's going on. I have been reading books, lots of books, lots of books. I'm about to finish the Nodos book. I'm in chapter 18, the last chapter of the book. I read a lot of stuff about Freemasonry lately, a lot of things going on. I do recommend a video called The Masonic Victory of the Masonic History of the, let me see, I have the name here somewhere. Oh yes, I do have a backup channel now on BitChute, but I only have one video there, which is not really mine. It's okay, by Dennis Wise. So The Secret Masonic Victory of World War II by Dennis Wise. Okay, now Dennis Wise has his own channel on BitChute, and this is a 20 episodes series, okay, like every episode is about 15 minutes, so 20. So what I did, I put it all together, I made one single video, it's 5 hours long. But I really recommend you to watch specifically from chapters from episode 13 to 19. It's really good. You see how evil this world is and who is in charge, how they do things, you know, to destroy humanity, and all these fires going on, like in Brazil, in the Amazon, Australia, and in North America, Europe. You know, I do believe on my heart that these fires are being caused by this elite, you know, by these people who want to destroy and put us all together, like, to bring the new world order, okay? That's what I believe, right? So, but I haven't been doing much Flat Earth stuff lately because I've been reading all this stuff recently. So it has let me discourage of even making Flat Earth videos because, I mean, we try so hard to bring change, to change everything, but evil is so powerful, and it's, I mean, we human people, we cannot really change anything. I came to this conclusion that we cannot. We tried, we had a good 2015 year, 2016, 17, until Google started making changes on the search engines, and YouTube deleted a lot of Flat Earth channels, so they have the power, they can disconnect us. They can disband all our flattered groups in a minute, you know, if they want to. Our groups on Facebook or channels, they can just delete them all. And we won't hear or be able to talk to each other again. Not even videos like these I wouldn't be able to make. So they're really powerful. It's really hard for us to go against them. Almost impossible. You know, like, we do need some spiritual help. And, you know, as a Christian, I believe only our Lord Jesus Christ can help us to defeat the enemy. Because he is, you know, he's the King of Kings. So, what else do we have for today? I think this is all. So, I do hope to be making another video pretty soon, talking about some of the books, showing the videos, the books that I've been reading, and share some of links with you, or maybe you guys read too. But it's very hard to make any change, real change, you know. We don't have the power. The power is in the hands of the evil people, and they are the ones who are, you know, taking us into this crazy stuff. It's the New World Order. I don't know why some people want to work with the devil and enslave their own children and grandchildren. But some people are willing to do anything for fame and fortune, right? So this is all for today. God bless each and every one of you. I miss being back. I've been talking to you guys, but, you know, because of this stuff, sometimes I just, even fixing things, you know, makes it hard, okay? I don't have t-shirts for sale. I ordered some for myself. You know, I don't have a shop or anything that I sell things now. And one more time, remembering you guys, reminding you, the PDF version of my books for free. You can find the link here. If you want to buy the real hard copy on Lulu, it's kind of expensive because it's an all-color book. So printing is expensive because of the printing shop, not for profit, but the content in color makes it really expensive. So God bless you guys. See you next time. Bye-bye. When you think airplanes are flying over Ball Earth, and then...
scare in the air for passengers on board an American Airlines flight. The pilot warning everyone on board that they would be landing.
You realize that an emergency landing...
But first this morning, a Qantas A380 carrying about 400 passengers had to make an emergency landing at Perth Airport earlier this morning.
Makes more sense on the Gleeson's Flat Earth map. It's in this moment that you realize...
a second emergency landing in less than 2 weeks.
That the Earth is not a spinning ball.
Last night here, we reported on that emergency landing here.
Breaking news, here is a live look at the San Francisco airport where a flight from Hawaii was forced to land because of a medical emergency involving a flight attendant.
Bogota to Frankfurt, emergency land in Manchester, only makes sense on a flat earth map. Hong Kong to Los Angeles, emergency landing in Alaska, only makes sense on the flat earth map. Chicago to Doha, emergency landing in Moscow, only makes sense on the flat earth map. Paris to Shanghai, emergency landing in Siberia, only makes sense on the flat earth map. Flight routes and emergency landings, the physical properties of water, the compass, gyroscope, radars and lighthouses, the lack of curvature, all point to one simple truth, that the Earth is...